Hello, and welcome to this sixth video in using Blender for video editing. In this session, we're going to talk about how to render out your final product, how to, after you've gone and done all your edits, how to generate that video file that you can then share with friends and family or upload to YouTube or whatever you want to do with it. As you can see here, I've already got something ready to go. I've already loaded up a video file. I've kept the audio portion of it this time. I've done some cuts to it and rearranged it. I've set my start and end frame range. And I've also gone into the properties editor to adjust the dimensions of the video to match up to the original dimensions of the source file. So what's left is everything that's specific to the rendering, which is all handled inside this same properties editor, and we'll go through things from top to bottom. First thing I'm going to do is expand that pane so I don't have to do as much scrolling. This button here, animation, that's the button that we will click on at the end because that's what will get Blender to do the rendering. But before that, we have a number of things to change, starting with display. If yours does not say keep UI, I highly suggest changing it to that, because what it does is then it tells Blender to just keep everything as is and not to start displaying something new, which will likely impact the performance and slow down the rendering. Now we'll scroll down to this section here, output. This first thing here is a text field which is supposed to give the directory and file name to render to. Right now it's just a folder, directory. You can click in that and I can type in a file name to go along with that so that I actually control what the file name will be when Blender does its render. If I don't give a file name, then it'll automatically choose a file name based off of the frame rendering range that we've set up. Instead of typing it here, you can also click on this browse button, and then you get this interface where you can choose your drives or your directories, and then also type in the exact file name here. So another way, like I could have done it there and press enter and then click accept, but in the end, you know, as you can see, it just adjusts the directory and file name as if we had just typed it. So either way works well. This option here, overwrite, it does as you think. You know, if that file already existed, then you, with this option checked, then it will just overwrite it. Otherwise, it won't do anything. Now here's the big one to adjust. Right now, this button here, it says PNG. If you click on that, then you get this file format window popping up. PNG is an image format, so by default Blender will output to a series of images, one per frame, but what we want is a movie, a video. So under here, pick FFmpeg video, and by the way, these things that I'm telling you to select, these are all the options that I use and they work well for me, so that's why I'm sharing these with you. After you've selected FFmpeg video, then you can go ahead and expand this encoding section and click presets and choose H.264 in MP4. That'll get Blender to adjust some of these settings automatically. And so the container, the codec, and the last thing to set is audio codec if your video has audio like mine does. So as you can see, I'll scroll that back up, you can see all these light blue strips here. These are audio strips. As you can see, they're type sound. So we have to click on none and then pick a value. I suggest AAC as the codec. Again, that's what works well for me. If you don't do that, then you go ahead and render, then the video file that Blender generates will not have any sound to it. Those are all the settings to change, so we can scroll back up and now we can click the animation button Once we do that, you can see that Blender shows a progress bar up here, and it also colors in the Blender window icon here in the taskbar. So that's a nice convenience right there. And once the rendering is done, you can go to the directory where it created the output file, and there it is, and I can double click on that and it'll start playing eventually. And there you go. So you can see here it's a 5 second clip, exactly what we had inside of Blender. So there you have it. That's how you can render your videos. I suggest you go and give it a try and mess around with the settings and see what works better for you. If you Google this, I'm sure you'll find many other articles and videos offering their advice on what settings to use. But again, these are the settings that I have been using, and they work great for me, so that's what I'm recommending to you. And that's it for now. So have fun, and we'll see you next time. Bye.